This is a $330 AIO from Thermalright. Has the world gone mad? Okay, maybe it's not entirely mad, especially when you hear the prices we actually found this AIO for. But anyway you slice it, the Thermalright Wonder Vision 360 UB ARGB all-in-one liquid CPU cooler brings premium features and a crazy big display into Thermalright's otherwise budget-focused lineup. Can it hang with other top-shelf offerings? Well, we're gonna find out right here, right now, on Robeytech, after a word from our sponsors. This video is brought to you by our official Robeytech build mat. If you've been watching the channel for a while, you'll probably recognize it. We love these things. They're super thick and durable, and they're absolutely huge in size, measuring at 5.5 millimeters thick and 24 by 48 inches wide. This one that we have right here, man, this has been in the studio for like 4 years and it's still holding up great, no problem. We've also included all sorts of useful graphics showing different PC form factor sizes, including schematic diagrams and connectors you'll encounter probably during your PC build. Not to mention, there's plenty of open space for screw and tool organization. We designed it like this so no matter what skill level of builder you are, it could be a helpful tool for pretty much everyone. Now, you can find these build mats for sale on our Newegg store, and it's a great way to support us directly if you enjoy the content we make. Thank you so much for your support, and let's get back to the video. It's actually crazy to think that the same company that has been dominating the budget CPU cooler space would start planting its flag in premium AIO territory with a flagship AIO that really is as eye-catchingly pretty as it is massive. That's not to call their other AIOs ugly. This one was just so unexpected that we knew we needed to get one in our hands and test it as soon as possible. So we're gonna test out the Wonder Vision, see how it performs, and take a look at its features. Because if this thing can go toe-to-toe in performance with other showcase AIOs, we could be seeing an option in this space that could free up money to be spent elsewhere. And speaking of money, we invested our own money to make this video because we just had to see what a $330 AIO from Thermalright would actually be like. So let's get to know the Wonder Vision a bit better, starting with pricing and where it lands in comparison to other AIOs like it. Now the Wonder Vision 360 UB is only available in a 360 millimeter version with options in either black or white. As for pricing, that's where things get interesting. Like we mentioned in the intro, Thermalright has the Wonder Vision listed with an MSRP of $329.90 on their Newegg store page, but they also have it discounted to $299.90. However, we saw it on Thermalright's Amazon store page for as little as $206. $120 is not an insignificant difference when you consider that you can almost buy two Thermalright Aqua Elites for that money. So basically, shop around if you're considering buying one of these because there may be a cheaper price elsewhere. Since price comparison is a little bit wonky, let's compare the Wonder Vision with AIOs with a similar defining feature, the huge display. At the time of making this video, Trikes is the dominant force in the space with the Panorama and the Panorama SE. These AIOs are retailing for anywhere between $280 and $360, which makes the Wonder Vision's MSRP make a whole lot more sense when you look at it in that context. Moving on to compatibility, the Wonder Vision wants to be everyone's friend. On the Intel side, it has support for current gen LGA 1851 and 1700 sockets, all the way back to LGA 115X, as well as LGA 2011 and 2066. As for the AMD side, it's no small wonder that the Wonder Vision supports both AM4 and AM5 sockets, which covers the entire Ryzen family of processors. Like I said, this AIO just wants to bring the cooling love to everyone, and the installation mostly follows this mindset. The Wonder Vision uses a similar set of brackets for installation like the ones we've seen on their frozen Warframe AIOs. These brackets tie into the existing backplate on AMD motherboards or the included bracket for Intel with a set of spacers for your socket of choice. Once those are in place, there are two posts that line up with the pre-installed nuts on the water block. Like we mentioned in our other reviews for the frozen Warframe, you'll want to make sure that you evenly tighten down these to ensure even contact with the CPU. Nobody, I mean nobody, likes poor contact. And if you want to make sure you have better contact with tech reviews like this one, build guides, and a healthy helping of dad jokes along the way, hit those like, subscribe, and notification bells both here at Robeytech and over at Robeytech Live. You know, it's just as natural to do as replacing the magnetic display cap module back on top of the pump head and making sure that it's plugged into an internal USB header. Now, what's a little less natural, and if it's been a while since you've installed an AIO, is that the cable connecting the Wonder Vision pump to the motherboard doesn't come from the CPU block, the connector actually comes from the radiator. Now the good news is that there's plenty of length on the cable, but if your case and the cable lengths are mismatched, again, finding an extension should be no problem. What you also aren't gonna have a problem with is seeing the AMO LED display on this thing because it's freaking huge. We're talking 6.67 inches from corner to corner with a resolution of, get this, 2400 by 1080. And with its 60 hertz refresh rate, this thing is as smooth as it is crazy big and eye-catchingly beautiful, especially if you want to use one of those 3D GIFs or as a wide canvas to display system information with funky animations behind it. All of the controls for the Wonder Vision screen are inside of the Thermalright Control Center app, or TRCC. This software does take a bit of getting used to with the way it basically handles layering, but Thermalright has done an excellent job of providing plenty of presets for users to get to know their screen. They've also fostered a community where anyone can basically build out and submit their own designs that other people can download and use on their own AIOs. And I mean, who doesn't want Bluey and their family dancing across their AIO display? Now moving on to the Wonder Vision's pump, Thermalright didn't give it a fancy name, but they did say that their new design pump operates with a 9-pole motor with a new fluid impeller that has a max speed of 6,400 RPM, give or take 10%. Now that's wildly high considering that an AIO that may or may not have inspired the Wonder Vision, called the Trikes Panorama SE, which you can actually see our review of right here, has a pump that's max speed is 3,600 RPM, give or take 10%. We'll have to see how this impacts performance in just a minute, but the pump is only one piece of the cooling puzzle. We need to talk about the fans and the radiator. Now, there isn't a whole lot to say about the radiator. It has a standard thickness of 27 millimeters. However, it does have that little bit of a bump out near the hoses. This is where the pump connector I talked about earlier is. As for the fans, the Wonder Vision comes with a pre-installed unified fan array with 320 millimeter fans, much like NZXT's Core series. This array is 25 millimeters thick, which is pretty average, and average is also a great descriptor for the fan's airflow at 69 CFM, or an air pressure of 2.87 millimeter H2O, and a noise level of around 27 decibels. Again, no outstanding specs, but also not altogether terrible. It's just average. What isn't average is the ARGB on these fans. Thermalright took a tasteful, minimalistic approach that really does add a touch of class without going overboard. With this being a unified fan array, there is only one cable to control all three fans, and that splits off near the end to separate the 5-volt ARGB and the PWM fan connections. Now that we have a panoramic view of what the Wonder Vision is, let's talk about the data. As a reminder, all of our AIO tests are performed in nearly identical Intel and AMD PCs. Notes on the screen for details. All of this is done under the same conditions to keep the data as clean as possible. Now we're gonna go through this pretty quickly, so feel free to pause at any point in the video if you wanna take some notes. Starting with our Intel bench at CPU idle, the Wonder Vision held thermal averages right between 29 and 30 degrees Celsius, leaning ever so slightly towards 29. This puts it in line with AIOs like Thermalright's Frozen Warframe Pro and the Vitru Lurker V360. While this average is on the warmer side of our charts, remember that these numbers represent system states where our CPU is hardly working. When our CPU is working hard under full CPU load, the Wonder Vision reminds us of why Thermalright has been a thermally right choice in the budget market. With an average just below 80 degrees Celsius, the Wonder Vision was at the cooler end of our charts with other Thermalright AIOs like the Frozen Warframe Pro and the Frozen Note. For example, this was about a degree and a half away from the Li Galahad 2 Lite, which has been dominant in our thermal charts, but how did that translate into Cinebench scores? Well, the Wonder Vision doesn't have as strong of a showing here. With a score of 33,204, it hovered near the lower end of our charts with AIOs like the Lurker and the Gambius Xeon E4. Now, when we look at the average wattage here, the Wonder Vision is allowing our CPU to pull just north of 243 watts, which is on the higher end of our averages. Again, neither of these are horrible metrics here, but we're also not seeing a stellar translation between power draw and measured performance. Now moving on to gaming benchmarks, the Wonder Vision averaged under 55 degrees Celsius, playing it near the middle of our charts with AIOs like the Montech Hyperflow and the Trikes Panorama SE. From a power draw standpoint, the Wonder Vision was at the higher end of our charts with an average just below 110 watts. Now moving on to the AMD side, the Wonder Vision sank to the higher end of our charts with an average temperature between 44 and 45 degrees Celsius. This time, it leans towards the warmer end. This positioned it next to AIOs like the Li Hydroship 2 TL and the Arctic Liquid Freezer 3 ARGB. But Those two kept their distance. Again, there's not a whole lot of action here. This is just one sits a little bit on the toastier side. However, under full CPU load, the Wonder Vision rallied hard. With an average temperature of a bit above 84 degrees Celsius, the Wonder Vision threw elbows at the Kraken Elite, bested the Frozen Warframe Pro, and wrote a strongly worded email to the Fantex Glacier 1 M25 G2, all AIOs occupying the cooler end of the performance charts. Will that turn the Wonder Vision's tides in Cinebench? Unfortunately, not so much. The Wonder Vision distanced itself from the rest of the pack by 300 points, and not in the right direction. As for power draw under load, the Wonder Vision did keep in step with an average between 144 watts and 145 watts. So we're not seeing a dip in power draw, but what we are seeing is this AIO giving our CPU plenty of headroom to draw power and to do the work. Now moving on to our gaming benchmarks, the Wonder Vision held average CPU temperatures under 60 degrees Celsius, placing it near the warmer end of our charts with AIOs like the Liquid Freezer 3 Pro and the non-Pro models. But to be fair to the Wonder Vision, it is allowing our 7700X to have one of the highest average power draws of 83 watts while gaming. Now moving on to noise levels, we recorded the Wonder Vision at around 51 decibels with our gaming benchmarks and just above 65 decibels with fans running at 100% under full CPU load. For context, the decibel range is like the difference between average room noise and having background music on. So unless your room noise or background music are aggressively loud, the Wonder Vision is probably not going to be a distraction. Okay, so one more data point before we put a bow on this one. Let's look at the relative value with some fancy math. As a reminder, we're dividing the MSRP by the difference between the CPU thermal max, which is 100 degrees Celsius, and the average CPU temperature under load. This gives us a dollars per degree of cooling value, which we can then score and compare. In this case, lower is better. These numbers are based off the data we collect from our Intel bench and the MSRP at launch. Understand, we absolutely expect these values to change, but you can do the math to see where things land today. With a relative value score of 15.6, the Thermalright Wonder Vision 360 UB is positioned at the higher end of our value proposition charts, right between the NZXT Kraken Elite and the Trikes Panorama SE. Now, if we're gonna use the equation with that $209 price tag we talked about earlier, this score would drop to a 9.9, putting it closer in value with AIOs like the Be Quiet Silent Loop 3 or the LCD-equipped Li & Li HydroShift 2 CL. So with all of that in mind, is the Thermalright Wonder Vision 360 UB worth considering as your next AIO? Thermalright, they kind of blew our collective minds with this one. They gave us an AIO with some premium features, a stunning display, and a price tag that we're not used to seeing from this otherwise budget-focused lineup. Overall, the thermal performance, it was decent, balancing in places where we either were more or less impressed with its averages, but one of the things we saw it do fairly consistently was go toe-to-toe with the Trikes Panorama SE, trading wins and losses when compared. And really, that's a big thing we needed to see, because if you can find this AIO for $209, the Wonder Vision is absolutely wild for what you're getting. A show-stopping AIO that performs well enough for games while still providing good headroom for thermally taxing CPU loads. Is it the strongest performer? No, but if you're building a flashy showcase PC, but you're still trying to be mindful of your bottom line, the Wonder Vision 360 UB ARGB has helped us catch a vision for a great way to save a little without sacrificing on style. Again, it's not the perfect AIO, but it still is a perfect addition to Thermalright's lineup, though we still want them to keep churning out those sub $100 AIOs. So those were our thoughts on the Thermalright Wonder Vision 360 UB ARGB, but now it's time to know what you think. What do you think about the Wonder Vision's design? If you were shopping for an AIO like this, would all of the features, design choices, and performance be enough for you to pay full MSRP, or are the cost reductions a good move? And what do you think about Thermalright having options in the premium AIO space? Should they stay in the budget lane or give us more options here? Let us know in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here at Robeytech or over at Robeytech Live. And if you wanna continue the conversation, maybe ask questions about these videos or AIOs or whatever, head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. It's an amazing place to talk to other tech and PC enthusiasts about stuff just like this. And you know what? You might just make a friend. Also, make sure you follow us at Robeytech on all your favorite social media platforms. And if you made it this far, I want to say a huge thank you for sticking with me throughout this video. And I look forward to seeing you on the next one.